Evening students, so today's class we read about the rest of the rational numbers. So in previous classes we have already discussed about the different properties of whole number, integer and the rational numbers. These properties are closure properties, commutative property and the associative property. So this all about we have discussed. I hope you understood that. Then today we solve some examples given in your book. So in page number 9, example given to add this 3 by 7 minus 6 by 11 plus minus 8 by 21 plus 5 by 22. So by using associative property, first you add two numbers, then rest the two numbers or rest one number. You can do that procedure also. Otherwise, to solve this, you can find out the LCM of 7, 11, 21, 22. So, LCM, if you find out the LCM, so you take 7, 11, 21, 22. If you take LCM, 7, 1, 11, 7, 3, 22, 21. Then 11, 1, 11, 1, the 3, 11, 2. So you multiply 7, 11, 3, multiply, and you will get answer 462. So here LCM, you put 462 and you can add here. If you divide 462 by 7, multiply 3, you know this procedure, not necessary to completely explain. I hope you know this. So, when you multiply 462, that is 198, plus when you divide by 11 and multiply by minus 6, you will get minus 252, then plus, then again you divide by 21 and multiply by minus 8. You get minus 176, then next you will get 105. So this answer has 198, here plus minus minus 252, minus 176 plus 105 by 462. When you solve, then you will get answer minus 125 by 462. You solve it. First you add these two number, then this two number, then you minus. But another easy process is there, that if you take two numbers, it is suppose 721, 1122. So it is easy now. 7, first you suppose take 3 by 7 plus minus 8 by 21, means 7, 21 Celsius is 21. Then plus minus 6 by 11 plus 5 by 22. So 11, 22 Celsius is 22. So partly you solve this. Then it will be easy to solve. Both procedure correct, but it will be easy to solve. So 21, 7, 3 is 21, 3 is 9, plus 20, minus 8. Okay. Then plus, here LCM 22, 11, 2 is minus 12, plus 22, plus 5. Then again 9 minus 1, how much? 1 by 21 plus minus 12 plus 7, how much? Minus 7 by 22. Again use 21, 22 LCM, then you can solve the answer. So this is the all about. Plus you could do yourself. Then come to example 2, multiplication. Suppose minus 4 by 5 multiply 3 by 7 multiply 15 by 16 into minus 14 by 9. minus 4 by 5 into 3 by 7 into 15 by 16 minus 14 by 9. If you solve, how will you solve that? So you can do by the procedure of lowest order, or you look at just too easy. Suppose I will just rearrange the numbers 4 by 5 into 15 by 16. Then first I wrote this two number, then 3 by 7 into minus 14 by 9. Now you got. So 4 1 ja 4 4 ja 16. 5 1 ja 5 3 ja 15. 3 1 ja 3 3 ja 9. 7 1 ja 7 2 ja 14. Then 1 1 by 1 into 3 by 4 into again 1 by 1 into minus 2 by 3. Again here you can put again 3 to 3 cut minus 2 minus 2 2 ja. So minus 1 by 2 is your, here 1 minus 1, so you minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 by 2 is your answer. So okay, then next I am saying to that the role of zero. What is the role of zero? Zero has no weight, but it has a great role in mathematics. When you add a zero left side of the number, no value change. When you write 0 right side of a number, it will increase 10 times. So the role of 0, if you add any number, suppose 4 plus 0, 4, 7 plus 0, 7, so no value changes. So 0 is called additive identity. So 0 is called additive identity. Why? Because when 0 is added with any number, then no value changes. So that's why 0 is called additive identity. Then come to multiplicative identity, or the role of 1. What? When you multiply any number with 1, no value will be changed. Suppose 4 multiply 1, so 4. 5 multiply 1, 5, 100 multiply 1, 100. So 1 is called multiplicative identity. So multiplicative identity is what? 1. So why it is called multiplicative identity? Any number you multiply 1, you get the same number. No answer will be changed. And 0 is called additive identity because when you add 0 with any number, no answer or the no value will be changed, you get the same answer. Then to come negative number. Negative number what? So negative number 5. Negative number minus 5. Suppose 3. Negative number minus 3. So minus 4. It's negative 4. So negative number or a number is called additive inverse. When I call a number additive inverse, suppose it is a number. If I write here it is number, then it is additive inverse. So 5's additive inverse is minus 5. 3's additive inverse is minus 3. Minus 4's additive inverse is 4. Why it is called? So when we add a negative number to a number, to its number, then we get the answer 0. So that is called additive inverse. Suppose question will come, what is the additive inverse of a number 5? So 5 plus minus 5 is 0. So minus 5 is additive inverse. Suppose is additive inverse of minus 7? Suppose minus 7 is given and you are said to find the additive inverse, then you add there plus 5 and your answer get 0. Here plus 5 is additive inverse, that means negative. So minus 7 plus 7, so is 7 is called additive inverse. So what is additive inverse? So given numbers negative, when you change it to negative, only negative, plus will change to minus, minus will change to negative, then it is called additive inverse. So plus 5 additive inverse is minus 5, minus 7 additive inverse is 7. When you add these two numbers, then you get 0. So additive inverse what? As additive inverse is minus a, if minus a is given, additive inverse is plus a. So then come to reciprocal. What is reciprocal? I hope you understood the negative number or additive inverse. Then come to reciprocal. Reciprocal means, that is, S reciprocal is 1 by A. 1 by S reciprocal is A. Okay? So, when you multiply two numbers, you get answer 1. Suppose given 5, what is reciprocal, or it is also called multiplicative inverse. So what is multiplicative inverse of 5? So by which number you multiply, when you multiply, you get answer 1. That means 1 by 5. How it is? You got 5 by 5, 5 to 5, you get 1. That is called reciprocal. S reciprocal is 1 by 5. So when you multiply a number to its reciprocal, we get answer 1. Obviously, A when we multiply. Suppose a fraction also given, suppose 1 by 8, when you multiply its reciprocal, reciprocal means 8 by 1, you just inverse it. So 8 to 8, 1 to 1, you get answer 1. So reciprocal is called multiplicative inverse. Suppose 5 given, 5's multiplication inverse is 5, 1 by 5. Suppose 7 given, multiplication inverse is 1 by 7. Suppose 1 by 5 given, its multiplicative inverse is 5. Or it's called reciprocal. Okay, so you understand what is additive identity, what is multiplicative identity, what is additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. So in short question, one more question in your exam may come, what is additive inverse, you have to say 0. What is multiplicative identity, that is 1. Additive inverse, it is negative numbers, negative of the given number, and multiplicative inverse or reciprocal is 1 by which number is given. Okay, so this is all about. Then suppose here examples, try this given page number 13, that write the additive inverse, write the additive inverse. Suppose minus 7 by 9, what is its additive inverse? So what I said, additive inverse means you must get 0 after adding. So minus 7 by 9 plus 7 by 9, answer will be 0. So 7 by 9 is the additive inverse. So what is the additive inverse? 7 by 9. Positive, negative number, you have right to positive. If positive, suppose here given 21 by 112. What is this additive inverse? Minus 21 by 112 means you just put a minus before it. Okay, then it is called positive, it is called additive inverse. That means 21 minus 112 plus minus 21 by 112. Then you solve it. 21 by 112 minus plus minus 21 by 112, answer will be 0. So here minus 21 by 112 is the additive inverse of 21 by 100. Then verify that the minus minus x is the same as x. Suppose how you solve the examples. 17. So minus x, x here given, minus minus x equal to this same as x. Means its value will again come to 13 by 17. How? According this put minus, then again put minus, and x value is 13 by 17. Okay. So minus multiplication minus plus, that is 13 by 17. Okay. So this like this you will solve the problem. Also example 5 here given page number 14 also you try to solve multiplications with minus. If any doubt you can ask me. So again next class we will discuss exercise 1. I hope you can do yourself. You try to do yourself, and then if any doubt you can ask in next classes, or now also you can ask me. This is all about today's class. Thank you.